controlling the league.
What the hell?
Father!
Get back!
You've never met a monster like Trigon. He'll bring hell on Earth.
You dare challenge us?
We're not in Kansas anymore.
Hi, this is Marc Morrell from ToonBarn. We're here at WonderCon 2016, and we're talking about Justice League versus Teen Titans. I'm here with Stuart Allan, who plays Robin.
Hey, guys.
How you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. After all, we are at WonderCon, like you said.
In the trailer for this, we saw Beast Boy say to you, or say to Robin, you know, oh my God, I think he really knows how to take down Superman.
Yeah.
So do you know all the same tricks that Batman knows?
I would say I know everything, but I know somewhat of the ins and outs just by seeing him work. It's just kind of a, like kind of the offhand experience working on the job.
They say at the beginning of this, Robin kind of botches the mission for the Justice League, and that's the reason why he gets sent to the Teen Titans.
Yeah.
So what did he do to botch the mission?
I'm not exactly sure I want to spoil anything, but let's just say that he causes a big explosion where he shouldn't have.
All right. So I guess if it was involving people getting hurt, that's a pretty bad thing.
Probably, yeah.
Okay. How cool is it that Robin is the character that sort of comes in the box set that's supposed to come with this DVD and Blu-ray release?
Oh, actually, this is the first time I'm hearing about it. Well, now I'm really excited. I'm gonna go buy one right as soon as it's released. It's released today, right?
This is the premiere today, and then it comes out on digital HD on March 29th.
Yeah.
And then Blu-ray and DVD on April 12th.
Okay, well, I'm definitely gonna go and get one. I'm just gonna do that, and I'm gonna play in my room all day long with it.
Okay, because we've seen in previous versions of these box sets other characters, but You sort of become a main character of this whole story.
Yeah, in a way. Damian, I like to relate this movie back to the triple T's. Teens, Titans, and teamwork, especially teamwork. Because we see in the beginning of the movie series with Son of Batman and Batman vs. Robin, Damian learns more about good morals. You know, justice, not vengeance. Straying away from Ra's al Ghul and moving over to Batman's side. And then the second two movies, Damian learns to take a leap of faith and trust people more. Because in the beginning of this film, we see that Damian doesn't like being a part of a team at all. He says a team is a bunch of squabbling doofuses who don't do anything. And that's why he prefers to work alone. And it's also, that's kind of also put into the fact that he never really had a real childhood. And the closest thing that he has to that is his relationship with Dick Grayson, who he kind of looks up to like an older brother, but at the same time calls him an unavoidable irritation. Yeah, but getting to work with the Teen Titans and kind of hanging out with with kids his own age teaches him to take some of the weight off his shoulders and let other people help him with the burden. He doesn't have to do absolutely everything. You know, he can learn to trust other people, even if he doesn't know everything about them. I mean, heck, he puts tracers on the Teen Titans 30 seconds after he meets them. Literally. Yeah, he doesn't really trust many people, but yeah, he learns to trust people more in the end, and he gets some friends out of it. Yeah.
I want to thank you for joining us on ToonBarn at WonderCon.
Thank you. Yeah.
I could have driven myself.
After the stunt you pulled, you're lucky to be allowed within 10 feet of a steering wheel.
So this is my punishment? Enduring a bunch of school children?
This is not punishment. Hopefully you'll learn to be part of a team. And they're not children. They're teenagers.
Worse.
Don't tell me Damian Wayne is afraid of a little socializing.
I'm not afraid of anything. Teammates are a liability.
Really? Then what am I to you?
An unavoidable irritation.